Remember the last time you had someone repair a home appliance, your car, or another piece of complicated equipment? Instead of a simple explanation, you may have been faced with words, concepts, and details you had never heard of. Sadly, many scientists are also guilty of precisely this when asked to explain their own work. Learning to correctly use jargon is a real coming-of-age experience for new members of any subculture, and science is no different. Finally, you understand what your peers are saying, and, even better, you can spell out your own ideas in the same way. It is only natural that you want to use this newfound vocabulary that shows you really belong to the tribe. But beware, specific terms like KD, Chandrasekhar limit, or onomastics are incomprehensible for anyone outside your close workplace community. Even terms that are trivial for you might be obscure for your audience, like convection, allele, or narrative identity. As a science communicator, you must remember that your scientist peers will understand your field-specific words, because they have received the same training as you. They have spent long hours listening to lectures and read hundreds of pages of specialized text. Other people with whom you are communicating have done neither. For them, the important, well-defined terms from a lab meeting can be literally meaningless. Even worse, some words have dual meanings. The colloquial meaning can be very different from the scientific one. If you are a molecular biologist, you might want to talk about your latest cloning experiments and, while you would be imagining stitching together pieces of DNA, your audience might picture the clone army from Star Wars. Or a cursory mention of models you work with might make some of your listeners think that the door to your lab door opens onto a catwalk. Cutting jargon will make you a more successful communicator, as your audience will actually understand the concepts you are trying to convey. They will appreciate it, just as you do when someone finally helps you understand what exactly is wrong with that car. Review your message with a focus on the words you will use. Are they jargon? Do they have dual meanings? Test them on people you know. They will probably be very helpful, but not your lab mates. Can you think of dual meaning words in your field? Share them in the comments. Please help us improve our project by completing this very short form. And don't forget to check out the other videos in the series and additional tips in the description.